Connected. User entered left your channel. Channel switched.
Unless you're in no hurry.
Hello.
Hi, all.
Hi, Tim.
Tim.
All right. Got a great group. Where are you, Week?
I'm back home, and I'm going to try my test I wanted to do the other day again, so I'm not flying with you guys.
Kim!
Hello!
So I am flying the task, but I'm flying it offline.
Hi, Kim.
Hi, Kim.
Hi, Kim.
Hello, hello.
Hi, Tim, and Brian, and Kim, and Week.
Hello.
Is the server going to go up?
Maybe.
There it goes. which plane to take?
I thought Discus was mandatory.
Yeah, I thought that was.
This thing's only got a 250 VNE.
Yeah, but if we're all running it, makes no difference.
Yeah. I think half the time I've ripped the wings off on start with this thing. I'm not going to do that today.
Is it the Discus 2A? I was going to see if I could purchase it real quick.
Yeah.
There might be a lot of people, though, coming in, Josh, so that's the problem. You might lose your spot.
All right.
This time of year.
Or if you're looking for a challenge, do take the Genesis. I mean, nobody cares. If you don't fly the plane because you don't have it, well, it's their fault for making a task with a non-standard glider.
Yeah, that's true. You can't expect everybody to purchase the Discus.
At least we haven't ran into an ASG 29 only task. I'm trying to think of the gliders that probably people. Well, actually, which one is the one that is the least purchased?
Probably the 126.
Or nope, about that full open cockpit wooden thing.
I know which one it is, but I'm not allowed to disclose that information.
And the, I was not asking or expecting you to say.
I would guess the Swift.
Not that one either.
My guess would be that new metal, all metal acrobatic, or that I can't remember what it's called. The Pleiades. That's what it was. Yeah, that would be my guess, but I'm just because it's new. And when I was looking at the Swift, I was kind of like tossed up between those two. I was like, well, no, probably the Swift is the one that has the high.
Yeah,
DNA,
or maybe the Pegasus, which is almost similar to the ASW-19.
Oh yeah. But it's got a brown cockpit.
Oh, yeah.
And if you fly it in real life, it's a nice glider.
I said the interior of it looks so 70s. It's really funny to me. It looks just tan and brown. It's like,
so, Tim, what was your verdict yesterday? Was the JS-1 the right plane, you think, or not?
Yeah, well, only if index was applied.
If what was applied?
Index.
Okay. Okay, well, that's that means no, it wasn't the right one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think just the EB, it depends on the task. If it's one of those really stupid, simple, just fly along and obvious ridge the entire way, then the JS one may have an advantage. But if there is terrain that you can bypass or cut past by just being able to fly fast and continue to climb with the EB, then the EB will do better. I think it's basically where it gained on there was it never. You didn't have to ever get low. You could just basically be flying a V&A and still climb because there's nothing to do about it unless you put your brakes out.
Got a good one, Bruce?
Yeah, just mediocre, but I got nowhere to go. Nothing's going to happen for 12 minutes, so whatever.
Yeah, that's true.
It's kind of about a 2, you know, average. It's a little stronger, but you can't keep it centered the whole time. Well, not at the high strength.
User disconnected from your channel.
Okay, well, that Topaz deserves a raise. He literally just flew me right through the thermal. Well, there's a new one off to the southeast. Ooh, is this thermal really narrow? Oh dear.
What'd you say about that tow pilot?
Well, no, my tow pilot was fine. That one was trying to kill me. I'm gonna go over this other thermal. New one. Right now there's a tow plane flying off into nowhere.
Nice paint job, Mike.
Thanks.
Huh, that's weird looking. The I try to figure out what's on the ground over here. Next to the river, there's like it looks like craters from bombs or something. It's just a bunch of little holes in the ground or circles. It looks really, really strange.
Is there any landscape that covers Ukraine?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Oh, wow, these are super narrow thermals.
Wasn't it a maxed out cloud penalty today, if I'm remembering right?
200.
Yeah. Remember that, guys. No flirting with the cloud. Yeah, this is dying.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check out this one up to the northeast.
It looks like a new one.
Yeah, brand new.
I'm still sitting on the ground, but I've been watching that one develop.
I'm gonna check another one because that one was 1.6 at best. And insanely narrow. I was having to circle like a 60-degree bank.
This one's been 2.2, 2.3, and pretty wide.
Okay, I may check this. This one's a little closer and newer. I'll hit it first, then go over to yours. Yeah, I know you can set the thermal strength and stuff up to absurd levels in the by editing the files. I never actually changed the variation up to high levels. I don't know if that's capped or you can set the variation to something insane.
How's that one doing, John?
I'll tell you in a minute, sir. I'm not centered at all in it.
Yeah, this one's down to 1.6, 1.7.
This one I'm in's 2.5.
I'm at 2.5 over here.
Anybody got the planes jumping around today?
You can see other.
My planes are in good shape.
I was gonna say you can see other planes from where you're at. I have literally only two people, AE and Dennis.
Up to 3 now.
This one's up to 2.2.
Boys and girls.
Hey Zoko.
Hey Zoko.
Hi Zoko.
Hello Zoko.
Yeah, I wonder how many female pilots there are in Condor.
Not many declared.
Twenty-one club, bitch. You look higher than that, Mike.
I'm almost 31.
Yeah, that looks like a really big clouds up there.
And it's still I've probably still got 50 to 60 meters to go.
Did you say 31?
Yes, sir.
Nice.
I just lied. It's 21.
You look like you're way up there.
And do not go to 2155.
Is this discus only task today?
Correct.
Sorry, I don't have one.
Ditto. I have the LS8.
Then for punishment for not buying it, you need to fly the Genesis.
I'm not flying Genesis. I'll just quit.
Put new landscape. Okay.
I wonder if that's Monterey, California, or Monterey, Mexico.
I hope it's not Monterey, California, because you already have the entire state of California. I can leave that map on there because it's a nice map. I hope we don't have a separate California map just for one little part.
We already do. They got a separate Truckee map.
Oh, I know, but I forgot to know the cal. Does the main California map cover all that?
Yeah. Well, no, it doesn't, because the Truckee map extends well into Nevada. Those people at that other cloud do look a lot higher, don't they?
Yeah.
But they're not. Maybe 50 meters higher. Golf Juliet's flying the Australia colors too.
Yeah, he does that.
Yep.
We have a nice little train of red, white, and blue.
Yeah, it is Mexico. So,
all this clouds,
Mexico again.
You might be able to climb through this cloud pretty soon, but I don't think I'm going to be playing games today with the cloud. Well, it's dying, so it's getting pretty feathery.
Yep. No, I'm just laughing at Zoko's comment.
Oh, I see. That's funny.
Too short fuselage.
Yeah. And which kind of religion is that?
Short fuselage religion.
So, Week, are we supposed to tell you something? I lost him. He was flying offline, he wanted to synchronize.
Oh, he'll want to know when the start pops up.
Oh, we lost him.
But I think we need to tell him that we're interested in the beta when it comes out.
Yeah, the problem with synchronizing between offline and online is you can't just use the join time, because this is the time period that's hard to figure out. The time between the end of the join time and the start of the launch, when all the people stuck on the runway are still launching, because that's a completely randomized thing.
If I was just guessing, I bet you he's beta testing 3 and wants to fly similar times of day and stuff.
Yeah, probably so. That would make sense.
So has there been any talk at all about when 3 comes out, or is it still pretty much blacked out?
Tim said it's going to be before Christmas.
Okay.
Yep. I'm pretty sure.
Couldn't comment on which year.
Yeah. Yeah, that is a pretty safe statement, I guess.
Yeah, that's bulletproof.
It's always before Christmas.
Well, we just want it right. We don't want them to rush it and screw it up, so.
Wait, what cloud bases were you guys getting?
21.
Oh, this one's barely 19. I'm at 1910, and I'm about to start scraping it.
What's the minimum start and the max start height?
14.
14.
Oh, there's everybody. As soon as I started flying back, suddenly everybody popped into view.
Okay, Musud's doing his normal first out of the gate thing, or almost first out of the gate.
Good luck, Kim.
Thank you.
Yeah, cool.
Good luck.
But it was not my intention to start. So I'm coming back, going back again, see if I can find a cloud somewhere.
This is a new cloud, friend? It is. Yeah, there is a new cloud on the southeast corner of the star sector.
Yep. I see it.
How about a new cloud down course? That's what I want to see.
I'm in something that's blue. I don't see a cloud yet. Very shortly after the start.
Oh, that's nice.
Trying to fly without Katasa, and I find that I'm using it too much as a crutch on what my max speed is.
Yeah, good luck, everyone.
Yeah, good luck, everybody.
Good luck.
Yeah, you got a cloud developing above you now, Josh.
Terrible start. How strong is it, Josh?
About 3.5 knots.
When you said 3.5, I had my hopes up just for a split second.
Yeah, right till he followed it up with that notch.
Yeah, that's nuts.
That's not good, man.
Nuts to that.
That's naughty of you to use knots for turbo speed there.
When I started Joss, I did knots as well. So if you just double it, then you won't surprise everybody. So it's 3.5, 4 knots is 2 meters.
It's really amusing how accurately that conversion is. It's really an interesting little coincidence.
Locked up for about 3 seconds.
Yeah, it happens to me a lot too, Bruce. I just had 5 seconds.
That's really long.
If you'll notice too, everyone keeps moving while you freeze, so you lose ground every time.
So most tasks you would be actually winner, but you get held back by the freezes.
Exactly. I was hoping someone would pick up on that.
Yeah, the freeze occurs when you are entering a new tile and it needs to update the signal.
Oh man, it's just going blue at the, on the start line.
They like put a little bit of multi-threading in Honda 3 to make the tile loading run on a separate thread or something. Easier said than done, but
they don't have a big crew working on this.
That shouldn't be a big that really shouldn't be a terribly complicated thing, because it's yeah, like the memory for where the textures and trains load in isn't something that's getting written to by another. Multi-thread gets really complicated if you have multiple different things writing to the same area. But for the scenery, nothing. Yeah, you just have one thread that loads it, and then the main program reads from it. So it's not nearly as hard to do. And that's the reason why like games and stuff can be hard to multi-thread, is because if you have like AI, if you're trying to like multi-thread AI operations and stuff, well, they're all like reading from stuff and writing their locations and memory and stuff, and if they all share the same space, you need to be really careful that you don't like have two different threads writing to the same thing at the same time. Oh, these thermals are so bad.
wonder how bad the ridge is going to be when we happen to find one.
Oh, I guess this one's not too bad. You picked a good one there, Mike.
2.8.
By far, this one's seen.
That's winning turbo.
But it's tight.
Good luck, Tim.
Good luck, Tim.
Thank you.
Yeah, good luck,
Tim.
I was thinking of doing the same thing. You got good lift there? I was kind of waiting. Hope I didn't run into anyone. So far, I'm having 3.2 in this one.
You're doing better than I am.
I'm about a 45 degree bank. I'm using the convenient angles on the dashboard for bank angle.
Averaging 3.7.
Good pitch. And Ken? You got a 3.7?
Yeah. At the start.
I wonder where he's at.
Start. I'm going to be starting.
Oh.
Me and DGT are dancing here back at the start. Jay, who's bought so far?
I got him in sight. Well, he's further up the path I'm planning on taking, so I'm not sure if that's good or bad.
He's been going down a lot lately.
This one maybe is slowly weakening.
How's that cloud, Rich?
It's rubbish. I'm just gonna leave.
Definitely. So, should we head towards mountains? The mountains or the mountains?
Let's go to the mountains.
Good luck, Bruce. Thank you. And I kept my wings, although they were flapping.
That's a design feature. It produces small amounts of thrust.
I think I'm the last guy. No, there's a couple guys behind me.
You're staying with your friend, BGT.
Yeah, he is right there. He's 1.7 in front, although, you know, I said bye-bye the other day, and it was a smart thing. You know, he took a bad way. That one where only like a third of the people finished. I really did well by not following him. He ended up beating me by a tenth of a point in that race anyway. Pretty blue, eh, Josh?
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing between here and the mountain ridge. Basically, the start in the mountain ridge, it's nothing.
Yeah.
And even east and west, wide open. Insane. Boy, I think it'd be tough to find a place during this task to go autopilot for a while.
You were saying?
Yeah, it sure wasn't on it for long. Man, DGT is really pushing it low.
Meters a second on this ridge here.
North or south of the blue line? East or west?
Right, yeah, east of it. There's a little section of the ridge that's parallel to the blue line. It was 4 meters a second for a moment. It's kind of dropped down a little bit as I got long. It's a little bit more. There's more spurs and stuff sticking out, so it's a little bit more rough, but for a minute it was really good.
Unfortunately, that moment didn't last a long time.
Yeah. It's not nearly so good now. It's not, like right there, I just hit four again. It's like you'll hit little bits of it, it's just that this ridge isn't very even. So it's kind of off and on.
Cloud up here on the line that everybody's running.
Thank you.
Sorry, Kim.
No.
Ah. Oh, sorry, Kim.
Oh.
There is no way the wind is changing constantly. It doesn't matter where you are. There is no lift anywhere. Oh, look. Let's see how far can we go.
Oh, this is a tough one, Kim.
No. Yeah, actually, German is more tough in my opinion. But there was not really anything to get up in any height. I could have been crossing around.
Is that any good, Brian?
After one circle, I'm 1.5 meters up. Still trying to pour it. Approaching two.
Man, I'm all alone.
Just above two.
I will even go and cook. So, for those who's coming to the Eurobattle, see you later.
See you, Kim.
Welcome.
See you.
Say that, Kim. Sorry, mate.
Okay, see you at the Eurobattle.
See you at the Eurobattle.
User disconnected from your channel.
Oh, I see a whole bunch of people up there. All of a sudden. Liking that, Rich?
It's not too bad.
Over three?
It's over 2.5.
SCR just disconnected. He wasn't low. Well, he was low, but he wasn't down on the bottom.
Maybe something came up.
Yeah, the grunt.
GT said no to your thermal.
I think it did a couple of turns.
I would rather be high on this part than low.
Problem is, it sucks down here.
Yeah, it's dying.
I stopped to take that because I didn't want to be too low getting into this higher ground. Bridges tend to work better if you can get higher on them.
Yeah, if you can ride the tops, it's the best.
Well, Rich, I did that thing where I planned on one map, and then when I went into the task, I didn't load the right map.
Oh, no.
But they don't, it's amazing how much just having the different, you know, format a map, how much different it looks. I mean, it's the same map, it's just a different, whatever, HB or whatever.
Oh, yeah. I've got different maps for, yeah, multiple different ones, because some of them are, they use different ways of doing the terrain shading and everything, so. Also, some of them, I think, are too dark. I tend to make a new version to them that are lightened up a little bit.
Well, drew all my lines on one format, and then you look at the other in the PDA, and it's a real joke trying to say, well, where are you? Really nice, Rich, going right over there.
I've got DGT ahead. He's circling. Looks like a dying cloud, but he's looks pretty low.
Yeah, he's not going anywhere. He can go east, but he can't go north.
Let's fly through and see what he's got.
Got 3.5 on this ridge. Not gonna last.
Well, he's climbing. I think it's off this ridge rather than the thermal.
It's a nice thermal here, Joss, if you can reach it. It's 2.9.
Excellent, thank you.
I hope it will last.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, I see Tim over there. He's high and happy.
Were you saying that was 3.9 knots or meters per second, Tim?
3 meters per second.
Okay.
6 knots.
Josh, unless I'm talking, it's always meters.
Yeah. Just needed a double check.
So DGT escaped, eh, Rick?
Yeah, but he's got himself another parking ticket, I think.
Make it over, Brian?
Oh yeah, I've got this. There's a little bit of ridge on this side. And then it works on the other side too, where it should.
Oh yeah.
Water holds some water in Condor.
Say again?
I said, I wonder which glider holds the most water.
Diana?
Oh, thank you. Yeah, how much is it? Oh, yeah. Is that 250 or something? Yeah, the discus, too, that was 203, it was. Just trying to remember which one's how much your bike carries.
Diana is 220 liters.
Cloud there?
Yeah, like. he's on a thermal, I think, that cloud there, but it doesn't look like he's going up too fast.
Well, none of them have been fast.
Oh, the wind just went to zero right here. There's a thermal. Well, they're almost 5 meters per second right here. Holy wow, at least not in this ridge combined with them. Yeah, I'm averaging over 4.5. I guess maybe he didn't look like he was climbing from the angle I was at because I was below him.
Man, I just don't see all that great stuff you guys see.
Well, I hadn't seen... this is the first time I've thermal since that first one I picked up way at the beginning. I mean, Mike ran. This is the first time I've stopped the thermal.
Mike's hoping he's not too low to hit that one.
I think it's one of the ones that goes along the ridge. So if you are downwind, I was well upwind of it. I picked it up. Yeah, you're okay. It's definitely attached to the slope. I'm gonna stick this one because that ridge gets, there's a valley up there, but it's kind of shallow. It's 4.1 up here, which is still very nice.
I just can't imagine.
Uh-oh.
Hmm?
That was close. Sorry about that.
Oh, that's okay. I saw it was going to be close. Good place to climb before we head down that valley.
Yeah, well, perfect place to climb.
The thermal button.
I broke. It's working.
I still think it'll be interesting someday to fly a attention task with thermal returned on. Just to see what weird way we change how people would fly. If we fly a lot more aggressively. That might be all the way up from 1.6 to 2.3. I've been taking a very conservative flight.
Wow, everybody's there. Party.
I'm just about at cloud base and it feels like it's dying.
Mike, you used it all. Stop it. Leave for some for us.
I think part of it also is the higher you get further out, clear out the way. I couldn't tell if it was dying when I left it, it was just less room left.
Brian used it all up. I didn't.
Okay. Blame it on me. I see how it is.
Well, you got higher than I did.
This is true.
Then you just flicked the switch up there.
Well, all alone again.
Curse of being front runner.
This one seems pretty good too. Again.
Don't let Mike use it.
I'm telling you, Brian's the one that turned it off.
I think Mike's got a big mouth.
This is nice, Silico.
Well, off the ridge now it's about 3.2, but it was almost 4 down lower. Well, I'm rushing forward before Brian and Mike ruin the turmoil. Yeah.
By the time you get there, they'll have sucked it dry.
Yeah, for one circle on 3 meters a second out. Two circles, it's 4.
Is there any Halloween stuff going on at school today, Tim?
No, not really. I showed some video production from last year where 6th graders made some short horror movies. And then they are going out to trick-or-treat tonight. But it's a pretty new tradition in Denmark.
Commercial Americana.
U.S. are turning all the kids into beggars on Halloween.
But it's grown in Denmark, I can tell. So. The kids are pretty hyped about it, so eventually their parents and grandparents will get hyped as well.
Yeah. Kid force.
So next part gonna be tough. There is no low valleys, it's all high ground.
Yeah.
Gonna make it over that, John?
Oh yeah. Unless I just hit, I think I'm out of sync. That cloud's like on top of the ridge. Okay, my sight over the ridge is going up, not down. So.
That's good.
Yeah.
I'm chickening out and going a little bit west.
Yeah, I hadn't planned to go this way, but those clouds were kind of lined up in the way. Yeah, I think the next thing is just finding the right rig to get you over the fastest without having to climb higher than you need to. Look at all those ridges up ahead will be lined up with the wind. It's just picking the right one.
Yep.
This one is not bad, Tim. Over three.
Nope. Yeah, very nice. I'm just behind you.
Well, I had one friend back here, but he landed. And disconnected.
You are pretty much left alone tonight, Bruce?
Yep.
Check your armpits?
Yeah. Brush my teeth.
But did you use gray water to fill your tanks again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, I haven't seen any cloud bases since before the start.
Problem is, it's getting pretty late.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, I hadn't noticed the timing.
Yeah, almost half past
got
four.
Got Tango Zulu in sight.
So, I think I'll have to rethink my way.
I think I'm going to just head for the nearest valley, even though it's going to be a higher one. Just because I don't... Now it's looking like the getting to those further valleys might be a little bit trickier.
I don't know, is this beginning of wave or something? But it's nice, I don't mind.
And there's eight. Severe lack of thermals for the mountains.
IK and I are going to thermal that Tango Zulu found.
Oh, that must be good. Yeah, I can't see where I'm at.
And Josh, you'd be happy. He's turning right.
Very nice.
Wish I had caught that time thing. I would have started right away.
Okay, I see someone at cloud base and a thermal to my left. They're far enough away, I can't see their ID.
Might have been me, I was right at cloud base. I just left it.
I can't see now. My wind's in the way. Really wish they were in that cloud this way.
I'll be darned, I got a friend all of a sudden. T1 is 6 km ahead.
Now to pick the right valley.
Door 1, 2, or 3.
I took door one. Because door one was the first door to get there. I was like, I had kind of wanted to go a little further down because some of the valleys are further to the east. Looked like they're lower to get through, but it wasn't looking like I was going to be able to get to them either. So climbing a little higher than I need to is better than getting stuck in some Army Valley, or you know, down low in one where there's no lift.
I feel like it could be like most extreme elimination, where they've got the doors that open and the doors that don't. Don't know if anybody else has seen MXC.
It has for a very, very, very long time since I've seen that.
Okay, I can see you, John. I think I'm going to be going one valley to the west of where you're at.
Oh, I see.
Just because it looks a little bit steeper. But I'll be hopping over as soon as I can. Tango Zulu is dropping water.
How far am I from turn point? That's 30 kilometers. I don't know if I want to do that yet. I can see the sense in doing that to get up faster, but I don't know how the distance from the once I get over.
Yep, it's an interesting tactic.
I'm actually doing it. Yep. Because this top speed on this thing is already low enough anyway. But I'm not going to be... I'm right at McCree 4.4 from Final Glide. So once I get over, I'm going to be going so fast anyway, it won't make any difference. Oop, oop, NOI and KU are coming in.
NOI is in the NEO.
Well, the lift is not good up here. Oh, man. Way worse than I was hoping it'd be, and it's really steep, too.
Finished yet?
There will be. Well, NOI isn't late. Yeah, NOI is, and he's still got a ways to go.
Jeez. They overdue. Seems like it's been a long time.
Yeah, it's still. Well, a lot of the targets are pretty tall mountain to get from over the end. Oh, there's just a tad bit of sink on this. Once you get over. There goes all my Final Glide rapidly degrading. They'll be left on the other side of the valley. I'm flying anyway.
Cross over where these ponds are?
I don't remember seeing any, but I can't say I was looking. But I don't remember seeing any ponds where I went over. Looking at Exosaur, it's like it went slightly past a pond.
I'm going to door number two. And there is loads in door number three.
Just hold on, flutter. Yeah, frankly, I'm not sure if dumping the water was a good idea or not.
If he climbs faster on the ridge, maybe it is.
Yeah, I mean, I had to climb and get over, but I'm also having to... I'm not flying at V&E on this final leg even, yeah, so I'm not...
Finally had a good thermal. T1 marked it for me, which was really nice. 4.5 up to about 2,500.
Nice one, Bruce.
Yeah, I needed that big time. Haven't found the energy.
Well done, John.
Congrats.
Great job.
Congrats, John.
Thanks.
What do you guys need to get over the last mountain range? How high?
It was somewhere around 23, 24.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
I know. And I can't go any faster.
That's fine. I know where you guys went is very different than what I went. But I scraped in right at the 800 meters. Did you dump water?
No.
Maybe that's a different thing. I lost so much more altitude on that. That found alive without any water.
Yeah. That'll do it. I'm coming in with, I'll probably have 1,700 when I get there.
Congrats, Mike.
Thank you.
That's Brian.
Thank you.
Congrats.
DGT is still going. Cool. Thank you.
Oops, John.
Oh, I don't know how I didn't count the clue who was that game there. I left my wing in the trailer.
That looks good for you, Shelko.
We'll see. Have to slow down a bit.
I think you'll be second.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Congrats, Shelko.
Oh, wow.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Welcome. You started after me and finished before. That's very impressive.
It's a miracle.
No. It's good flying.
We started the same way and then we had disagreement of which way to go.
Yeah. Thank you.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim. And congrats, Dennis.
Congrats, Dennis.
Congrats,
Tim.
Yeah, on the first part, Silco, you stayed on the blue line. I went somewhat to the left, quite a lot.
I started the kind of left north of blue line, but I was looking just the ridges ahead to go north.
Yeah.
And I guess it worked out better for me.
Yeah, it was a better way.
East or west of the blue line?
Well, started west, then ended up kind of east, and then moved west again. Zigzagged a bit.
Yeah.
That's. Yeah, look at Mike. I went east on the blue line, then more to the east, and then back to the blue line, then.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Well done. And finally, I beat KMI for once.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah, I'm going to get off of here and go bring up something to eat before the Euro battle.
I will see everybody.
Take a look
over your left shoulder before you go there,
tomorrow.
Mike.
Have a great afternoon.
See you, Mike.
You too, Mike. See you at
Eurobattle. See you, Mike. See you at Eurobattle, guys.
See you at Eurobattle, Mike.
Bye.
Oh yeah, now I'm looking at it, there was no way I was gonna fit between there.
User disconnected from your channel.
We'll see y'all guys later.
User disconnected from your channel. User disconnected from your channel.
See ya.
Oh, let's see where DDT ends up at. He's doing pretty good.
Let's see, how long till Eurobattle kicks off?
Less than an hour.
Okay, so sounds like a plan.
Quarter
see you guys
past.
In a bit.
Yeah, see ya.
Somebody was asking if the discus is a little better or not. Yeah, I think that if you can't be flying at V&E, the discus is better than the. But if it's a fast enough task, they all say we'll basically win every time.
Yeah, I'll say bye as well and see you guys.
See you.
Bye.
See you, Tim.
Bye bye. Have a nice
see
day.
See you, Tim. See you in your battle.
Yeah. Yep. See you.
Disconnected.